Okay, am I audible?
Yes.
Lovely, lovely. So, welcome back to day two. And basically today we'll be discussing a lot about layouts. Last session when we actually discussed, we understood that almost the execution part starts from layout. So today we will understand what are the principles or what exactly does this mean? हमें अगर layouting करना है तो करना क्या है? We'll see practical images, some logical understanding. I will take Q&A from you all. हम लोग layouting को बहुत depth में समझेंगे. Today we'll understand layouting in lot of depth. So apology. Before starting, apologies for yesterday. My father was not well and he was hospitalized, and hence I had to take a break for a day. But with God's grace, he's fine, and today I'm back taking the session. So let's move ahead and start with today's session. Before that, can I just hear a hey from everyone? Hi.
Hi.
Yeah, who's this? Swati. Okay.
Hi, Swati.
Yes, right.
Hi, out there.
Hi, Kanchanji.
Absolutely. Yeah, hi. Hope your father's doing well.
Yes. He's got back into the normal ward, and that's why I could get some strength to, you know, come back and do the session. That's how it is.
Sure.
Thank you. And Mr. Chiranjeev Bhattacharyaji, can you we just say a hi to each other and thereafter start? Hi, good evening, Mr. Chiranjeev.
Can you listen to me?
Yes, we very much. I can hear you. Okay. And Payal, if you could, Roshan and his sister had joined, but somehow maybe some link issue or what, if you could just check, you know. This is an important session.
Riya is having class, but Roshan is joining. Yeah.
Okay. All right. So they can watch the recorded session as well.
Yes.
Okay. Fine. So let's go ahead and check out the interesting topic, how to create a layout for graphic designing. This is one of the most important thing which a designer starts with. Let's say if one is designing a car, he starts with a silhouette, a very basic lining of it. Similarly, if we are doing a graphic design, in the last session we discussed about layouts, and today we will practically see how to do it and how to create it, and while creating, what all to keep in mind so that we create a very good layout, a very good foundation to start with Canva or any other software for the matter of fact. So these are important theory. Do not miss it. And in case, let me shift to the next slide. The class objectives and rules. I'm trying to make it little creative in the PPT, but at the same time, basic, the way we would do it in any class. I would expect you to make notes. Yes, we have recorded sessions. You never know, this is technology. At times, a recording session can have any sort of error. So make sure you record the make notes of these.
Shall we get this recorded records?
Yes. Yes, we will share that. It's already on Zoom link. We are just waiting for the Microsoft app to be regularly. There is some new thing which we are understanding with the app, and we are trying to update that. However, the recordings are there on the Zoom, so it can be referred at the later date as well. We'll be sharing it in a day or two for sure. But all these sessions are recorded. Okay. So now that we've set the ground rules, let's understand the objectives. Our objective is to understand the importance of layouts before starting to design any project. And the golden rules of layoutings are, let's go ahead into that. But before understanding the golden rules, first we need to understand the importance of layout. I've been repeatedly telling you all this, but I'm purposely repeating this topic because it is very, very important. First one, it is the foundation of your design. You start any design with a layout. They give your work a structure. Okay? Anything that you want to create, when it has a structure, a building, any floor building, whether it is four floor building, whether it's a bungalow, which is just one floor, or whether it's a high rise of 50 floors or 100 floors, each and every building always had a basic structure, which was created in AutoCAD or any other. So similarly, when we are doing a graphic design also, we should have a clear structure. So that is what layouting will work on. Next topic is, it will help the viewer to easily navigate, form the margins on the side to the content. And then it will be helpful to, sorry for the spelling mistake, helpful to create graphic design, web design, and apps as well. So what we are talking here is a person who has come to see your, or is standing and seeing your artwork somewhere. If your artwork has a layout or has a structure, he will be able to easily navigate through what you want to communicate. We'll understand with pictures in the later slides. And it will be helpful to create graphic design, web design, apps, etc. on the software part. And without a layout, your work will fall apart and be ineffective. Okay? So make sure always have a layout. And this is the first step on how you start to think like a design. Okay? It is very important when you want, if you're a cricketer, it's very important that you think like a cricketer. How the ball bounces, how it's coming onto the bat. If you are a bowler, you will think about the wind. There are so many other things that you will connect to. So similarly, when you want to be a designer, any designer, here we are talking about specifically with graphic design. But it's very important to think like a graphic designer, or whether you're designing something else than like that particular designer. Okay, so let's move on to the important topic for the day. Let's understand. This. Now, I've tried to make it colorful, basic, yet appealing, so that these points you all always remember. Because when you want to think, you need to have certain principles. Can anybody type in the comment box, what is a principle? Not the teacher in the classroom, but or the principal from the school or college, but can someone type in the chat box? The main concept, yes, okay. It's the main concept, okay. What else? Anyone else who would like to try? Theories, yes, okay. Okay, so let me try to simplify what is a principle. If I create something, I need to think. We started with that, okay. So to think, we need certain parameters. For example, when we do animation, we have basic principles of animation, which helps us create that. But when we are doing a layouting for graphic design, what is that which will help us to actually create those? So principle is something which help. It's those 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you do these checkpoints, it's also called as checkpoints, you know, that this is the principle which will help you to create an effective graphic design. So let's quickly read them one by one. So the first one, or let's say this is no hierarchy. This is just randomly which I have put. So we have topics such as focal points. Focal point, if one remembers, we discussed in the last session as well. Repetition. Okay. So another principle of layouting is repetition, alignment, proximity, contrast, negative space. Okay, I'm going a little slow if someone is making notes. Hence, I'm going a little slow. Always remember, these principles will help you create a excellent graphic design layout, and thereafter, the results, the topics which we discussed yesterday. Okay, so all those things we will be able to create with the help of these principles. Moving on to understanding these points a little bit better. I know you must be feeling, अरे बाप रे इधर तो बहुत सारा खिचड़ी जैसा है, but आगे जब हम जाएंगे हम एक एक point discuss करेंगे. But to give you a quick understanding, let's look at the examples of repetition. First let's look at repetition. So what is repetition? Key aspects of layout design. Okay, repetition is basically key aspects of layout design. It helps to create a continuous theme, feel, or look. So this one here is the example. Let's just quickly check. I'll use the annotations. Why is this not going? Chat session. Come on, annotate. Okay, yeah, done. So this example right here, this is the first example of repetition. So can someone just unmute yourself and tell me what is repeating in this image?
Well, the signatures of aircraft.
Okay, this is getting repeated, right? So what we call this is elements. Okay, please make a note. Yesterday we discussed at one point where this word had come. We have to use elements, but not too much of elements. But here we are seeing they are being used smartly in repetitive mode. Even for the matter of sake, this particular lime-like thing is being repeated. This actually gives the design a sort of a theme. You know, when you want to create a theme, your color scheme, your elements, as I said, elements, now we know what are elements. These icons that we put in any design, okay, these are nothing but themes. And these are nothing but elements. Okay. And we add this to enhance the supporting. See, what is the text written over here? Let's read that first. Have passport, will travel. So these elements are related. Always keep in mind, do not just randomly add elements. Always add elements which supports the story. What we discussed yesterday. Hamara ek story hota hai jo hume create karna hai graphic design ke through, right? So always add elements, okay, which will help the story. Which, kyunki visually hum log jitna dekhenge, visually log jitna dekhenge wo utna hi zyada usko recall karenge, utna hi zyada they'll be able to understand. Yes, dotted lines are also elements, of course, because anything that you're seeing which is like a creatively done or with lines, colors, these are all elements which you are adding to the, since this is the first image, I'm going into detail. Now, next few images, I will go a little fast, but the first image I wanted you all to understand, I'll just clear this again and re-explain that these are the elements. I'm including the dotted lines as well. So definitely they are also part of elements. And what we are actually talking about is repetition, not element. So let's not mistake the topic. The topic is repetition. And if you can see, it is being repeated twice. They have not filled the entire they have not filled the entire thing with repetition. Okay, so that is also a key. Visually appealing hona chahiye, humne bas bharna nahi hai. You don't have to just fill this. Okay, so it can be seen in color palette. Aap log repetition color mein dal sakte ho. So you can see yahan par yellow repeat ho raha hai, pink repeat ho raha hai. Ye jo pink hai, ye dekho element mein bhi humne unhone just to give the theme pink, उन लोग ने रेपिटेशन में कलर को भी रिपीट किया, नॉट जस्ट द एलिमेंट. प्लीज कीप इन माइंड, आप कलर भी रिपीट कर सकते हो. इनफैक्ट व्हेन यू रिपीट, आप एक थीम बनाते हो. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट लाइन. इट कैन बी सीन इन कलर पैलेट यूज्ड थ्रू आउट एज डिजाइन और बाय यूजिंग सिमिलर स्टाइल ग्राफिक्स एंड शेप्स. So this is a very important paragraph to understand. Repetition mein kya kya aap include kar sakte ho. Okay. Any person having any doubts, unmute and ask a question regarding this. Or because aage aage jab hum jayenge, aap mein se har ek ko iska answer dena hoga. I will be putting up images. To aapko usme kya dikh raha hai? You will be answering. So, agar nahi samaj rahe, ask now. So, let's go ahead and ask a question. Agar repetition pe koi hai to, anybody? Not there? Or can you all unmute yourself or you cannot? If any error, type in the chat box.
We can,
right? Okay. So moving ahead, I think it was pretty much simple to understand. Because main jitna simply aap log ko samjhau, wo utna aap log usable kar paoge. Main complicate karke bada bada designs bataunga, aap log ko wo samajh mein nahi aayega. Okay. So the whole point is that. Next is focal point. Yesterday we spoke about this. It starts the viewer's journey and in a hot spot to capture or grab his or her attention. Yesterday we spoke about, can anybody recall which image was that?
Apple.
Exactly, absolutely correct. The Apple one, it actually grabbed someone's attention and we can see it has a recall value as well, you know? So it's very important. We'll now brush through the next images because in as we move ahead in detail, we'll be talking about each one of them. So focal point is something which will actually grab your attention. We will see in detail how in the coming slides. Next one is alignment. Alignment by the meaning of the word itself talks about how nicely the text is aligned. It is mainly connected to the text part. Okay, so we will see in detail how we can give importance to that one. We'll see it. Let's move ahead. I'll just clear the annotations here or drawings. Okay, next one. Yeah, contrast. So हम लाइफ में हम जब कॉन्ट्रास्ट में चीज देखते हैं ना, अगेन लाइक वन टॉपिक विच वी जस्ट डिस्कस्ड वाज फोकल पॉइंट, राइट? कॉन्ट्रास्ट बताने के लिए जो हमारा मेजर ऑब्जेक्टिव होता है दैट इज टू क्रिएट अ फोकल पॉइंट. ओके, सो व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट प्रिंसिपल्स, आप लोगों के दिमाग में आना चाहिए था अभी तक कि हमको एक प्रिंसिपल यूज करना है या मल्टीपल प्रिंसिपल यूज करना है. कि यहां तो कॉन्ट्रास्ट दिख रहा है, ओके, और जिस हिसाब से ये इमेज दिख रहा है, द वे दिस इमेज लुक्स, इट आल्सो हैज अ फोकल पॉइंट ओवर योर, लेट्स एनोटेट दैट. सी, दिस कैन बी आल्सो एन एग्जांपल ऑफ अ फोकल पॉइंट बिकॉज immediately my attention goes to the word best because it has been highlighted with a yellow background, some element has been added at the back, and it immediately grabs my attention. So always keep in mind, one artwork, one graphic design artwork, jab aap layout kar rahe ho, usme multiple, okay, I'll just quickly erase this and yeah. Okay, usme multiple points ya fir multiple hamare jo principles hain. I'll come back to this slide because this can help us understand in a much better way. Annotate, clear, clear all drawings. So, ek image mein ho sakta hai aap focal point choose karo as your way of communication of the graphic design. Jisme help ke liye aapko repetition lag sakta hai. Okay, ki aaju baju jo elements agar aapko dalne hain to usme aap repetition dal rahe hain. Alignment humne samajh liya. Of course, usme aapko alignment karna hi padega. To hum samajhte hain is image mein hum log ne one, we used how many? One, two, three principles to create the layout. Am I making sense? Type yes in the comment section because that can help me understand whether, you know, aap log ki samajh pa rahe hain ya nahi. Jo maths hum log khel rahe filhal, one, two, three. Okay, Swati saying yes. Okay. I'll repeat myself. When we are talking about principles of layouting, what we need to do is, जब हम लेआउट बना रहे हैं, ये चीजों को दिमाग में रखते हुए हम लोग वो लेआउट डिजाइन कर सकते हैं. वी कैन डिजाइन द लेआउट इन अ मच सिंपल वे. डिजाइन बनते बनते थोड़ा बहुत आप लोग एलिमेंट्स और ऐड कर सकते हो या फिर प्रिंसिपल्स और ऐड कर सकते हो. आई वुड नॉट सजेस्ट बिकॉज बाय देन आपका क्लाइंट ने ऑलरेडी वो अप्रूव किया है, बट थोड़ा बहुत ब्यूटिफिकेशन आप यू कैन ऐड. बट ऑलवेज कीप इन माइंड दैट वन डिजाइन कैन हैव multiple principles of layouting, and that is why we are studying all of them at once. So moving on to the next one after contrast, we'll be discussing that one by one. Next one is proximity. Proximity is something basically wo na division karta hai. I'll tell you how. Okay. Going back to this image, proximity basically divides. Division number one, division number two, division number three. And it separates each, but wo jo similar elements hote hai na, unko nazdeek karta hai. We will discuss this as we go to this particular topic and this particular topic. Have you explained contrast? Yeah, we will get into that. We will get into that. Hum detail mein aage jayenge. Okay, I'll quickly show you all what is the next slides. So if you see this one, clear all drawings. What's this? Agar ye dekhiye, hum detail mein aur baat karenge on each one. So do not worry.
Okay. No, I yeah. think you were explaining contrast, and in the meanwhile, you switched to something else. And
no, we will. Okay. We will be coming to it. So I took that liberty of moving a little right. fast. Okay. Or else aaj ka bhi session kafi lamba jayega. And then fir I will repeat, you know, wahan par jab hum aayenge. That is why. Don't worry. So coming to proximity, as I said, this will help you divide the image into multiple elements. Har ek element ko alag rakhega ya fir hamara story ko alag, 1, 2, 3 mein divide karega. Okay? We'll come to it. We'll see in detail. Negative space, one of the most important one to help you clean to help you keep the image or the feel of the artwork clean. Let's say agar hum ye wala slide jo maine banaya dekhenge na, isme negative space bahut kam choda hai maine. But can someone tell me isme negative space maine kahan choda hai? Just unmute yourself. Black part? Yes, absolutely. Because wo black part main dena chahta hun as an empty space for someone to completely defocus. Black part pe dekhna hi nahi hai. In fact, ye image aise lag raha hai ki black part pe zyada dhyan ja raha hai. But when agar yahan par ek interesting image hota na, we'll see examples ahead. तो मेरा ध्यान सिर्फ इस पे होता, ओके okay? एंड जैसे यहां पर कोई एक अच्छा आर्टवर्क आ जाता तो मेरा ध्यान ये ब्लैक पे से कंप्लीटली हट जाता था और सिर्फ ये आर्टवर्क पे होता. एंड दैट इज वाई नेगेटिव स्पेस इज समथिंग विच यू गिव एज अ ब्रीदिंग स्पेस बिटवीन द एलिमेंट्स, बिटवीन द इमेजेस, बिटवीन द कलर कॉम्बिनेशन, एनीथिंग दैट यू पुट इन इट हैज अ लॉट ऑफ वेटेज. तो जितना आप ओपन स्पेस सोचोगे उतना थिंकिंग एरिया मिलता है टू द वन हु इज सीइंग योर आर्टवर्क. ओके, सो ऑलवेज कीप दैट इन माइंड. ओके, वी विल डिस्कस दिस एज वी मूव फॉरवर्ड.
Is this negative area does have a background, something which is still there as an artwork, or it will be completely black?
We'll come to it. We'll come to it. Because it is not just about the color. We'll come to it. We'll come to it.
Sure.
So, repetition. I think repetition we humne bahut acha detail mein samjha. I think it is something which is very simple in nature. And repetition... हमने देखा कि किस तरह हम एलिमेंट्स को यूज करके रिपीट कर सकते हैं. सो आई थिंक वी कैन मूव टू द नेक्स्ट वन. बाकी सारे हम डिटेल में जाएंगे. फोकल पॉइंट, दिस वन लेट्स स्टार्ट अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस इन डिटेल. सो आई विल टेक माय एनोटेट ऑप्शन. ओके, फोकल पॉइंट, इट स्टार्ट्स द व्यूअर्स जर्नी. ये इमेज देखते हुए ही मी एज अ व्यूअर, माय इमीडिएट जर्नी इज व्हाट, इज टू फोकस ऑन द गोस्ट गेमर वर्ड और द एंटायर थिंग व्हिच इज विजिबल टू मी. इट इज सच अ पॉप आउट. नाउ इसमें अगर हम लोग क्विकली जस्ट अभी जो आपका लास्ट क्वेश्चन था, ये आपका क्वेश्चन था कि ब्लैक हम कैसे यूज किए. इन दिस we have that as a which one
negative
which one negative
negative this thing negative space.
Exactly. So the black becomes the negative space. It is completely defocused. You know, the minimalism design ka jab hum creation karte hain, this is where or this is how the artworks look. There is a slight element at the background where, you know, the galaxy sort of a feel that we are trying to give, but that is also very subtle. Or you can call it as, if you are an artist, you would call it as a splash of paint or whatever you call it. But mera focus kya tha ki mere ko ye gamer, I want to show the audience very clearly, we are talking about a ghost gamer. That's it. So that's all my focus point for this artwork was. We'll be seeing more examples, but always remember a focal point grabs the attention. And again, how can we play with focal point? It can be a shape, it can be an image, or a typography. Right now, what we are seeing is a typography. Typography is nothing but playing with fonts, different type of fonts. For first timers, आप लोग ने आई एम श्योर यू नो टाइप ऑफ फॉन्ट्स आप लोग ने कोई भी सिंपल सॉफ्टवेयर पे यूज किया होगा या आप अपने फोन पे भी टाइप ऑफ फॉन्ट्स चेंज करते हैं. कैन एनीबडी टेल मी इन द ग्रुप हु इन्वेंटेड फॉन्ट्स? एक्चुअली कंप्यूटर पे फर्स्ट टाइम फॉन्ट्स किसने लाया? एनीवन?
अ ह्यूमन बीइंग.
वाओ, I think you can do much better. Definitely he was a human being, but can you name the human being?
No.
You all carry his creation every day. Not all, but most of you all. Look at the chat box. It's him. Okay. Steve Jobs. He was the first one who actually bought fonts to computers. Otherwise, it was just one simple font in any other, you know, that's MS-DOS karke pehle aata tha, ekdam basic numbers and zeros and ones, binary mode pe. Oh, sorry, I think bahut jyada ho gaya. But always keep in mind, fonts ko interesting banaya Steve Jobs ne. First time he bought types of fonts in an operating system, which was for the Macs. And from there, the types of fonts became so famous that all the other interfaces always had Windows. Windows is by Microsoft, but iOS is by Apple. So they have different interface, but font types was first introduced by Steve Jobs. I am talking about this because we are talking about typography, which is nothing but fonts. Okay. So as I said, focal point. In fact, aap jab repetition bhi karo na, tabhi bhi aap usme fonts use kar sakte ho, typography use kar sakte ho. I will show that example as well to you all. Okay. So hamesha yaad rakhna, jab hum log play kar rahe hain to create some amazing layouts, hamare paas kya kya hai? Shapes hai, images hai, typography hai, colors hai, elements hai, you know, lot of things to play with to create some interesting concepts. And again, jo hamara Canva software hai, usme kafi sara ready-made bhi hai. When we will actually, jab hum Canva use karenge na, hum ye sare concepts use karenge to create that. Nahi to kya ho jayega? Canva to aapko ready-made de raha hai, aapko kabhi graphic design nahi samjhega. The whole point to get into this theory is to make you all realize how to actually do graphic design. Okay. So any doubt which creeps up to your mind about focal point, ask.
So when we basically do a graphic designing, we take care of the focal point, which is what we generally wanted to, you know, show.
Right, right, right. Yes, yes.
And the other things like the negative space or the alignment and everything supports the entire focal point in terms of bringing it out louder.
Absolutely, absolutely. So, and it is not compulsory that we always do a focal point. It's as a graphic designer, it is my choice. There are certain times when we have multiple focal points in, but then that's not a hoarding. Usually when it's a hoarding, when it's something which is very eye-catching or very minimal, that is when the focal point is most important. We will see a few examples as we go forward. But always remember, the most striking way of creating a graphic design is using focal point at its best. Even a cameraman always tries to adjust his focal lens to the main hero or to the main character that he is trying to show to the audience. Okay. So that is what, as it rightly says, it starts the viewer's journey and is a hotspot to capture or grab his or her attention. Agar mere ko viewer ka attention kisi gun pe leke jana hai, to main gun ko focus dunga, baki sab blur karunga. Simple as that. Kya dikhana chahta hun? What exactly I want to tell the audience? It's all about that. Okay. And this principle helps you in it. Okay. Moving to the next one. Alignment. Now, can you all see these slides are purposely kept bahut hi subtle tarike se rakha hai maine. If you see, mere paas sirf 1, 2, and 3. These are the only 3 things because I want you all to easily understand here. Jab maine ye upar wale slides banaye, see, agar aap log presentation bana rahe ho, wo chahe school ka ho, college ka ho, business presentation ho, ya kuch bhi ho, ye cheeze aap log use kar sakte ho, jo maine aaj, what I have created, the way I have created this presentation. Here, purposely, I wanted you all to be jumbled. I want you all to be confused here. So I've added a lot of things. But as we move forward, when I want you all to think clearly, see how much space I have given. See how much, less the more is what we are talking about here. And your focal points are minimum. 1, 2, 3. Okay. This is how simply you should say when you want to say, when you want to confuse, you should confuse. That's how you become a storyteller. वो चाहे इमेज में बोलो, फिर वीडियो में बोलो, मूवी में बोलो, या एनी हाउ. एज वी डिस्कस्ड इन द लास्ट टॉपिक और इन द लास्ट सेशन, अ लॉट ऑफ अबाउट इट, स्टोरी स्टोरी स्टोरी. तो जिसका स्टोरी आप बोल रहे हो उसको फोकल पॉइंट पे डालो. ओके, मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट वन. हम लोग ऑलरेडी इधर आ चुके थे. कमिंग बैक टू द टॉपिक, अलाइनमेंट. एक्सट्रीमली इंपॉर्टेंट इफ यू वॉन्ट टू मेक श्योर दैट योर वर्क इज प्रोफेशनल. जितने भी रूकी वर्क होते हैं या फिर फर्स्ट टाइमर्स होते हैं ना, आपको पता चल जाएगा द वे द टेक्स्ट हैज बीन अलाइंड. ये जब एक लाइन में नहीं होता है, ओके, आई विल जस्ट यूज annotations over here. When this is not in one straight line, you come to know this work is by a rookie. Okay? Hamesha yaad rakhna ki alignment of the text is very important. There are times jab aap log usko right alignment karoge, middle alignment karoge. Ye jab hum software pe kaam karenge to ye zyada important rahega. Keep this in mind. Alignment is something which aap jab ye bana rahe ho. ओके, ये एक इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट है विच आई एम गोइंग टू जस्ट टेल यू ऑल. कीप दिस वन थिंग इन माइंड, देर आर सर्टेन प्रिंसिपल्स विच यू विल, आई विल गो बैक टू माय इंपॉर्टेंट माइंड मैप. आई कॉल दिस अ माइंड मैप. समथिंग लाइक अ अलाइनमेंट, ये आप कब यूज करोगे? सॉफ्टवेयर में यूज करोगे. क्योंकि जब आप लेआउट बना रहे होते हैं, आप वहां डिटेल में इतना काम नहीं करोगे. तो वहां लेआउटिंग, हाँ, आप डिफाइन कर सकते हो ये लेफ्ट अलाइनमेंट रहेगा या राइट से स्टार्ट होगा या लेफ्ट से स्टार्ट होगा. यू कैन डिफाइन दैट, जस्ट फॉर डिफाइनिंग इज गुड. बट व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट टेक्स्ट अलाइनमेंट, दिस एक्चुअली यू, व्हेन यू आर वर्किंग ऑन द सॉफ्टवेयर, तभी आपको काम आएगा ये ज्यादा. बेसिक डेफिनेशन आप दोगे उसमें. And alignment is not just about text. Yes, it is. It talks a lot about text, but always keep in mind, ki jo ye entire artwork mein ek alignment hai. The entire artwork has an alignment, which is called as, ye kaun sa side ho gaya artwork ka? Left side. So we call it a left alignment. Are we getting my point? हम कोई भी आर्टवर्क बना रहे, चाहे वो YouTube के लिए थंबनेल हो या कुछ भी हो, हमने एक साइड टेक्स्ट को दिया, ओके, हमने लेफ्ट साइड टेक्स्ट को दिया, हमने राइट साइड किसको दिया? इमेज को दिया. अभी मैं आपको एक और इंटरेस्टिंग फैक्ट बताता हूं. आई एम श्योर आप लोग ने सुना होगा इसके बारे में, बट समझा नहीं होगा इतना इसको. कितने जन को ब्रेन का लेफ्ट एंड राइट आइडिया है, होता है ब्रेन में दो साइड होता है?
और मेरे को.
वेरी गुड. तो लेफ्ट वाला कौन सा होता है? लेफ्ट होता है. अभी बोलना नहीं, लेफ्ट वाला लेफ्ट होता है. व्हाट इट रिप्रेजेंट्स, कैन समवन टेल?
लॉजिकल.
यस, प्लस एंड माइनस नंबर्स.
राइट इज क्रिएटिव.
यस,
राइट थिंकिंग, क्रिएटिविटी.
एग्जैक्टली, एग्जैक्टली. सो कैन यू सी हियर हाउ दे हैव यूज्ड लेफ्ट साइड एज योर टेक्स्ट, विच इज योर लॉजिकल थिंग. लेफ्ट ब्रेन मेरा, यू नो, टेक्स्ट पढ़ रहा है. राइट ब्रेन मेरा इमेज देख रहा है. सी, दिस इज व्हाई कॉन्सेप्ट्स आर सो इंपॉर्टेंट, कि हमें समझ में आए कि एग्जैक्टली मेरे को लेफ्ट में टेक्स्ट क्यों डालना चाहिए. मेरे को राइट में, आप उल्टा भी कर सकते हो, यू कैन डू इट रिवर्स एज वेल, बट माय माइंड इज ऑलरेडी हैज अ स्ट्रक्चर, सो व्हाई नॉट टेक द हेल्प. और आपका ऑब्जेक्टिव क्या है? कि ये जो मैंने बनाया किसी के माइंड में घुस जाए. दिस शुड एंटर इन समवन्स माइंड एंड नेवर कम आउट. दैट इज माय ऑब्जेक्टिव. सो व्हाई नॉट यूज द ब्रेन्स पैटर्न एंड क्रिएट समथिंग यूनिक, एंड हेंस alignment can be taken to that depth as well. And when we are talking about a professional work, is always very well aligned. Any questions? Go ahead. Before we move on to the next one. Are we good?
Yes, sir.
Okay, cool. Let's move on to the next one. Contrast. हम सिंपली समझ सकते हैं कॉन्ट्रास्ट को हमेशा वो देखने पे ही पता चल जाता है कि बट यूजुअली इसमें दो चीज हम समझने को ट्राई करते हैं. लेट मी क्विकली आई कैन टाइप इट सो आई जस्ट यूज दिस. ओके सो व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट क्लियर ऑल ड्रॉइंग्स व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट कॉन्ट्रास्ट चैट बॉक्स लेट्स गो इनटू द चैट बॉक्स आई विल टाइप इट ओवर देयर. ओके we have to talk about always background and foreground. What is background? What is foreground? Can someone just tell me? Ye artwork mein background kya hai? Koi bhi?
The background, yeah. Can I say?
Yeah, go ahead. Go ahead.
The background is yellow and the foreground is the text written in black.
Okay, you are very close, my dear. But the yellow is just the highlight part, which we discussed.
Okay.
The background is white.
Frame.
No. Frame is actually not part of it. Sorry to confuse you. Because wo fir dikhta nahi, isliye maine wo frame add kiya tha. The white... Yes, but you know, if you would have been right, agar main usko bhi consider karu to, the white portion is the background. Okay. And the black portion is the foreground. Jo black mein text likha hai, wo foreground hai. So, ye do terms pe contrast khela jata hai. Yeah, we play the contrast game with the help of these two terms, background and foreground. But you can be right. Okay, when we are specifically talking about best and that yellow part. You getting my point?
Yeah.
Hum jab specifically sirf agar ye dono cheez ko dekhenge, which is the best and just this part. To isme aapka answer sahi hoga ki ye background hai iska aur ye foreground hai. But hum ye pura artwork jab dekhte hain, to isme white section becomes the background and this contrasting text, again it's being played with text, it's being played with colors. To samajh mein aa raha hai na aapko, jaise jaise ye cheeze repeat ho raha hai ki hum ye principles kuch alag nahi hai, alag hame duniya se kuch aur nahi karna hai. We have to again stay on the basics. All we have to do is use the colors, use the font, use the elements, use a certain shape to create these differences so that hamara artwork unique bane. Audience jis tarah sochte hain, the way the audience thinks, we can actually hit their mind with a bullseye and they remember our artwork. You know, abhi aaj jo aap log ye dekh rahe ho na, these artworks will remain in your mind at least till tonight. उसके बाद का मैं गारंटी नहीं देख सकता बिकॉज यू विल सी अ लॉट ऑफ अदर एड्स एज वेल. जो मैं दैट डे आई वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट वन एड हैज टू बी शोन टू यू ऑल एट लीस्ट 40 टू 50 टाइम्स इन अ डे टू यू नो टू बी ट्रिगर्ड ऑन टू योर माइंड. दैट इज हाउ मच बिग कंपनीज उनका एड प्रेजेंट से भी हो जाता है. जैसे कोको कोला का आप टीवी में एड देखते हो, बाहर जाते हो तो एड्स देखते हो, जब आप शॉप्स में जाते हो तो कोको कोला देखते हो, जब बॉटल पीते हो तो देखते हो, उसका ओपनर पे आप लोग कोको कोला. मतलब देर आर सो मेनी वेज दैट दिस पर्टिकुलर ब्रांड एक्चुअली गेट्स हिज प्रेजेंस. सो कमिंग बैक टू द इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक दैट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, दैट वी हैव टू कीप इन माइंड कॉन्ट्रास्ट. एनी टाइम वेन यू आर क्रिएटिंग अ स्टनिंग आर्टवर्क, a stunning layout at the basics, जब हम create कर रहे हैं डिजाइन को, always, always see if you can add this principle. It will automatically create another interesting layout principle, which we call as the focal point. ये automatically create करेगा. आप जब ये artwork देख रहे हो ना, इसमें आपका white में बहुत कम ध्यान जा रहा है. But immediately ये जो yellow आ गया, text पे तो जा रहा है, but yellow ने तो पूरा ही focal point खींच लिया अपना. Yellow ने पूरा ही खींच लिया. But अगर ये yellow नहीं होता ना, तो आपका ध्यान first immediately किस पे जाता? Black पे. Immediately your attention would go there. So contrast helps you to create that focal point. Okay, if you can read this, extremely useful for creating focal point. It balances the image and adds weight to the visual appeal of the object. Jis cheez ko hume, jis story ko hume bolna hai. With this ad, what we are trying to say is live my best life. तो ये कीवर्ड्स हमने रिसर्च में जनरेट किया था कि हमें ये टेक्स्ट लिखना है, या फिर हमें वी गॉट दिस फ्रॉम द कॉपीराइटर कि दिस इज द कॉपी जो आपको डालना है. लिविंग माय बेस्ट लाइफ. नाउ यू एज अ ग्राफिक डिजाइनर शो हाउ यू कैन यू नो शो इट टू द वर्ल्ड. सो दिस इज हाउ वी चोज टू शो इट. लिविंग माय बेस्ट लाइफ एक टाइपोग्राफी स्टाइल में हमने लिखा, उसको इंटरेस्टिंग वे से उसको कॉन्ट्रास्टिंग कलर दिया. We gave it a contrasting color. And to highlight the most important word that I want to tell in the story, or the client wants to tell in the story, best. That was the word which we want to stand for, probably, which my brand wants to stand for, best. So, usko highlight kar diya. Bahut hi simple cheez, peeche ek element dalke, which is nothing but it looks like a brush stroke. It makes it stand out. So these simple things can actually help you create some stunning, stunning layouts, and thereafter work with softwares and create some good design. Moving on to the next one, proximity. Now, understand this one in a very simple way, okay? Or let's say I want you all to understand this one. Because you know it is slightly tricky, ye jo topic hai, proximity. Let me read the text first. Design elements that are linked in some way. I repeat, design elements that are linked in some way to be grouped together. Iska matlab kya hai? Ki jo bhi maine as a designer मुझे बोलना है थ्रू माई आर्ट वर्क, देर विल बी सर्टन ग्रुप ऑफ थिंग्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन दिस आर्ट वर्क, लेट्स ज़ूम इन अ लिटिल बिट मोर. सिल्वर किचन क्या रहेगा? ये सिल्वर किचन क्या हो सकता है? नेम ऑफ द ब्रांड. ये क्या है? लोगो ऑफ द ब्रांड. तो ये दोनों को मैंने किधर रख दिया? साथ में. आई केप्ट बोथ ऑफ दीज थिंग्स टूगेदर. समझ में आ रहा है आपको? ब्रांड नेम एंड लोगो, दीज आर वन थिंग्स. तो हमने उनको साथ में रखा है.
सर द पिक्चर्स आर नॉट क्लियर.
इज इट विथ? बिकॉज मेरे सामने फोन भी चल रहा है, या मेरे सामने ये भी चल रहा है. मैंने इनफैक्ट जूम भी किया हुआ है, तो काफी क्लियर आ रहा है. कैन यू चेक द इंटरनेट कनेक्शन? आई थिंक दैट कुड बी द इशू. जस्ट क्विकली स्विच ऑन स्विच ऑफ योर इंटरनेट.
वी कैन ज़ूम. इंटरनेट इज ओके.
इंटरनेट वीडियो क्वालिटी थोड़ा गिरा होगा, जिस वजह से वो वैसे हो रहा है. ओके, मैं आपको ये इमेजेस शेयर कर देता हूं, इट विल हेल्प यू. बट अभी कैसे? इज इट
मतलब stretch, you can stretch the screen,
zoom karke ya aise kuch? At my side is fine. Yeah, no, because main phone pe bhi dekh raha hu, because I want to understand these logics as well, and isliye meko to bahut clear aa raha hai wo.
Yeah, okay, it's good. Okay
all right, thank you. So next thing is a tagline of the company. उसको मैंने यहां place कर दिया separate, okay? Because directly connection नहीं है उसका logo से, but उसके नीचे रखा है, but ये एक separate. फिर मुझे मेरा जो tagline क्या है और company क्या है, खाने को लेके. It is either a restaurant or by a chef. तो मैंने और elements क्या choose किया है, images. तो images को मैंने एक साथ रखा, ठीक है. So I'll repeat the text what I've written at the side. Design elements that are linked in some way to be grouped. तो हमने क्या किया, text को एक जगह रख दिया, images को एक जगह रख दिया, text को एक जगह पे रख दिया again. But अगर उसका meaning में जाएं ये text के, तो ये तो था कंपनी का लोगो, ये था रिप्रेजेंटेशन विद पिक्चर्स, एंड दिस इज द एड्रेस एंड कॉन्टैक्ट डिटेल्स. तो इनको अलग रखना. सो प्रॉक्सिमिटी इज नथिंग बट क्रिएटिंग दैट फाइन डेफिनेशन कि बाबा ये अलग है और ये अलग है, ये अलग है. मेरे को ऑडियंस को क्या बताना है, ये अलग है, ये अलग है. मुझे ऑडियंस को बताना ये अलग चीजें हैं. इसका एक बहुत अच्छा एग्जाम्पल आगे और है, हम वहां पर और क्लियरली जाएंगे. बट आई रीड द नेक्स्ट लाइन. इफ यूज्ड करेक्टली इट कैन हेल्प यू स्ट्रक्चर योर डिजाइन. सी ये जो लेआउट बनाया ना अपने, इसमें एक स्ट्रक्चर है कि पहले मैं किसके बारे में बोलना चाहता हूं, कंपनी के बारे में. फर्स्ट वी टॉक अबाउट कंपनी, okay, then we talk about products. Am I making sense? Can we type yes or no in the comment section, because it is very important ki aap ye theory samjho. Main isme bahut time isiliye dal raha hu. Last we talk about the address. You know, don't you feel ki ye actually main pehle mera, agar aapka company mein hota to aap yahi chahoge na ki pehle mera company ka address and about wo aaye, फिर उसके पिक्चर्स आए, फिर उसके आई नो काफी सारा खिचड़ी दिख रहा है, अभी मैं वो क्लियर कर दूंगा. बट इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट ये है, 1, 2, 3. ओके, मेरे को यस नहीं आ रहा है कमेंट सेक्शन में, तो कैन समवन आस्क द क्वेश्चंस अगर कुछ डाउट है तो. Hello, good morning.
I am very much clear.
okay, fine. So from Binay also we received the yes. So I'm happy. At least I know, thoda bahut ye abhi bhi confusion rahega, but aaj jab aap log isko back to back study karoge na, when you actually write down, and jo main aapko ek assignment jo dunga, wo aapke sare doubts clear kar dega. That will, you know, further open this up, the topic. So I'll clear this, clear all drawings. Moving on to the next one, negative space. And this is also the last one. So when we talk about negative space, also known as white space, it's not about color, okay? Hum aisa nahi sochna ki ye color ke bare mein. Usko bola jata hai. It is also known as white space. It is not about color. Keep that in mind. Always keep that in mind. Negative space is not about color, but it ends up. जैसे अगर मैंने स्क्रीन को खाली छोड़ दिया तो या तो वो व्हाइट आएगा या तो ब्लैक आएगा by default. So it is. It looks like as if negative space is about color, but it is not about that color. हो सकता है मैंने background पूरा yellow कर दिया. So then फिर black and white में तो नहीं खेलते ना, बहुत बार colors में जाते हैं. जैसे for example, let's change the image. Let's assume that we are talking about negative space in this artwork. This by default took white. Okay? But when I come to this, can we tell which one?
see the light blue shade, the background.
Am I also mute by any chance?
No, hello? Sir.
Okay. Yes. So, Roshan, you tell me. According to you, which one is the negative space in this? It's okay. Go ahead. Even if you're wrong.
Negative one is kind of like blue in the
Why?
Red.
Why blue?
Because you don't want us to see that side of the world. In fact, you wanted us to focus on orange and the image and the words.
Yes. So blue is the negative space. But let me simplify this now. I think we are getting too confused because the word is reverse. Hum jab negative sun rahe na, actually, we are trying to search something negative in this. Okay, now that's how the definition came. We don't want something to be seen. No, it is not that. Anything that you leave as a space between two elements. And by default, it's your background. Wo hamesha negative space, hamesha apne jo background choda hai na, wo apka negative space ho gaya. Agar wo color, dunia ka koi bhi color ho. Your background color is your negative space ka way of indication. Okay? Wo indication hoga, but wo negative space nahi hai. So to simply understand, आपका जो भी background color है उसके basis पे हम judge करते हैं negative space. But हमें यह समझना है कि हम negative space छोड़ते क्यों हैं. For example, I will talk about a very simple example of आप लोग अभी मेरा screen देख रहे हो फिलहाल, right? इसमें negative space दिख रहा है आप लोग को? ये जो पेज है एक पेज, कैन यू ऑल सी अ नेगेटिव स्पेस इन दिस? विच वन, विच कलर?
द बैकग्राउंड वाइट.
एब्सोल्यूटली, इट इज दिस सिंपल. जो बैकग्राउंड कलर है वो नेगेटिव स्पेस है. बट थोड़ा उसको और डिटेल में समझो. आई हैव लेफ्ट अ स्पेस बिटवीन दीज टू आर्ट वर्क्स. एम आई राइट? Is it making sense to all of you all? ये जो भी खाली खाली जगह है ना, ये जितना आप ज्यादा छोड़ोगे उतना easy होगा understanding में, उतना easy readable होगा. That is why we need to make sure, क्योंकि जो भी नए लोग artwork बनाते हैं ना, they try to fill the screen. We'll just quickly use Canva.
Basically, you're saying that negative space is required for neat and clean.
Yes. I know I'm not able to simply say that, but the whole point is that aap log ko pura wo detail mein samajhna zaruri. Okay, I want you all to understand that in detail, so that there is no doubts in anyone's mind, Baba, what is negative space? Because it is confusing. I know first time when I learned it, I know how simple it was for me that time. So negative space is nothing but a method to simplify the design. Main abhi aap logo finally ek simple definition. Pehle mere ko aapko confuse karna tha. To maine confuse kiya. Abhi main aapko ek simple definition deta hu. Negative space is nothing but simplify your design with lot of open spaces for the viewer to think clearly. Yahan jitna bharoge, can you think clearly when you see all this? Until I fold this into pages, like a pamphlet. तभी हम क्लियरली सोच पाएंगे, क्योंकि हमारा फोकस सिर्फ उतना ही भी एक पेज पे होगा. बट अगर मैंने इसको इस तरीके से दिखा रहा हूं, द वे आई एम शोइंग दीज स्लाइड्स, you're able to understand, you're able to breathe. Achha, itna hi hai. Okay? So negative space is to create that itna hi hai wala feeling. कि मेरे को बहुत ज्यादा इंफॉर्मेशन नहीं पढ़ना पड़ा. आई डोंट हैव टू रीड अ लॉट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन. इन मिनिमम आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड. सो एन अ पर्सन हु इज वॉचिंग योर आर्ट वर्क, वॉचिंग योर होर्डिंग, वॉचिंग योर विजिटिंग कार्ड, शुड सी ओनली थिंग दैट इज नेसेसरी. ओके, इन फैक्ट I could have, you know, reduced a lot of focus from this. I could have done that. But yeah, that's a feedback. I'll take it. I'll keep it for the next session. Okay. Coming to the next slide. Yeah, feel free to ask questions, definitely. But now, we will come to questions. Now, I will pick and choose our team members, and I will ask one by one to check this image and tell me कौन सा principle आपको दिखता है. Before that, हम लोग quickly एक recap लेते हैं before going to that, so that आप लोग को याद हो जाए. Recap के लिए आते हैं हम लोग हमारा important slide. First one we discussed, focal point. What was focal point? When we want to focus on a particular thing only, when we want to grab attention towards a certain, towards a certain object, towards a certain text, towards a certain image, can be anything, tab hum log focal point use karte hain. Repetition, humko yahan par repeat karna hai hamare layouts mein cheezein, colors, lines, text. We can repeat those to create a repetition effect. Alignment, more of technical, जहां पर हम alignment text को एकदम properly करते हैं. That is when we talk about technical alignment. But the way the layout is designed, हम उसको भी alignment में लेते हैं कि left side में पूरा हमारा text है, right side में हमारा image है. We have image on the right side. That can also be called as alignment. And this makes your work extremely professional. Coming to the next point, that is contrast. Contrast mein bahut hi simple hai ki hum background and foreground mein khelte hain. We play with background and foreground to simply create a unique or a striking way of showing something to the audience. Proximity. जब हमारे पास काफी कुछ होता है बताने को, यू नो, व्हेन देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स. इनफैक्ट यू कैन सी वी हैव एडेड क्वाइट अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स टू वन आर्ट वर्क ओवर हियर. सो व्हेन वी हैव लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स टू ऐड, इट्स बेटर टू गो विद प्रॉक्सिमिटी. यू नो, बहुत सारे ब्रोशर्स, पैम्फलेट्स, ये सब डिजाइन होते हैं, प्रॉक्सिमिटी का बहुत ज्यादा यूज किया जाता है. एंड लास्ट बट नॉट द लीस्ट, नेगेटिव स्पेस टू क्रिएट दैट हश, आई डोंट हैव टू रीड टू मच वाला फीलिंग. Also having enough space. See, even in proximity example, there is negative space. This, I'll use annotate. This space, okay, I'll use a different color, white. This is your negative space. This is your negative space. This is your negative space. Because it should look free, you know, the viewer should have free mind to read this. If you will fill his mind with a lot of things, when somebody will talk a lot and not show anything to you, you will not going to understand anything. Okay? Yahan par in between also there is this, you know, empty space. So all of this is negative space. It helps to differentiate. It helps to give the audience enough time to think on what you want to say. Repetition, sab kuch ho gaya hai. Let's quickly go to the sample ones. Okay, now I'll pick one by one. Who wants? Anybody wants to start first?
Take it from me.
Right. Okay.
Okay. Let's go ahead with Swati.
Okay.
I'm going with what I can see first on my participants list. So okay, let's start with Swati. So Swati, according to you, in this image, what exactly are the principles that you can see?
I can see the principles which are used is repetition and symmetry.
Can you explain repetition?
Repetition. Yeah, because it's the print, the orange color, the print, it's overall spread it on a square block box.
Okay, so the color is being repeated. Okay.
Yeah, the color has been repeated all over in the lines. What I'm going to describe, the lines which have been drawn means check boxes.
Right.
And the design which is been shown is a symmetric in shape.
Yes. So that is which one? Out of these four, six principles, that is which one?
Focal point.
Okay. Explain how you think focal point is there.
Let me see the design. Because the canva is written in between.
Forget about canva. That is just this thing that has come. Forget about that. Aap usko bhul jaiye.
Okay. And the fiery design which has been showing. Which I can see means the leaf petals for or the whatever the symbolic image it is been showing that I can consider is that a focal point?
No.
Or the orange color?
अगर ये बहुत अच्छे से दिखता ना तो ये होता जो आप बोल रहे हो ना जब ये इमेज बराबर दिखता तो होता वो फोकल पॉइंट मेरा इमीडिएटली मेरा ध्यान वो इमेज पे जाता बट अभी तो नहीं दिख रहा है तो मेरा फोकल पॉइंट कौन सा हुआ सो देन व्हिच वन इज माय फोकल पॉइंट
दैट द काइट शेप्ड डिजाइन
नो लीव दैट दैट्स नॉट अ डिजाइन कैनवा का ट्रेडमार्क है वो सो जस्ट लीव दैट असाइड
ओके देन आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड दिस
ओके आई विल पुट इट सिंपली आई गॉट यू दिस चीजी बर्थडे कार्ड आप आर्टवर्क देखते ही आपका दिमाग उधर जा रहा है तो वो आपका फोकल पॉइंट होता है ओके वन सेकेंड अभी इसमें नेक्स्ट कौन सा हमारे पास ऑप्शंस है इसमें का लेट्स से फोकल पॉइंट हमने देख लिया रेपिटेशन देखते हैं रेपिटेशन किधर है उसमें रेपिटेशन है बाय एनी चांस चीज को तो देखो ध्यान से There is lot of repeated cheese in the image. Okay. Repetition mein aaya wo. You know, it's a graded cheese. So repetition aaya hai. We have itna bariki se aap, look into fine details of the image. You will get to see almost all of this in it. Ye jo hum dekh rahe na, almost all dikhega.
The alignment is there.
Alignment is there. Contrast is there. White and yellow straight away.
Correct. Contrast is there.
Negative space, so much negative space is there.
Yeah.
Can anybody explain proximity kaise dikh raha hai isme? Is there proximity in this? Can anybody explain? Swati, can you attempt? Since it's your turn,
okay.
Can you attempt?
Me?
Yeah. Attempt proximity on this. Attempt. It's okay even if you're wrong. But you know, that will make your mind think on it.
Okay. Proximity, the meaning is the distance, right?
Ha. You got it right. Abhi just image mein don't know na distinction ke tarah isme.
The sizing which been the image is been designed means...
Very close.
Yeah. Yeah, means it's very proper size. What to say?
It's such a proper division of one side being the text
and the cheese picture,
and one side being the image. This makes it since you did the first attempt, you've done a very good job. So I'm really happy. Kuch to basics ja raha hai dimag mein. This is how proximity is being put in this design. Very clear definition of what is on the left and what is on the right. Okay? And that is what we were talking about when we were talking about proximity in this. Let's go ahead and re-look at the proximity one. Dekho, yahan division hai. Main aap logo ko wahi bata raha tha. Division 1, division 2, division 3. Similarly, wo art layout mein do hi division hai na. Jahan par ek side text hai, dusre side
image.
Exactly. Now, this is how you, main ye images purposely rakha hun so that it makes you all think. Okay, Mr. Kanchan, can we go ahead and, you know, use the next image as your reference point? I'll just bloat the image a bit. So that, okay, yeah.
So I can see the focal point as an enroll now.
Exactly. Kyunki mera seedha dhyan kis pe ja raha hai? Enroll now. And that is what is the key of creating an artwork for a, in fact, ye kya rahega malum? This is something which will immediately trigger my mind ki mujhe karna kya hai? Action.
True.
Any artwork or any marketing artwork, video or whatever that is, it has to trigger an action by the audience jo dekh raha hai. So enroll now kya ho gaya? Mera focal point ho gaya. Wow.
The negative space is the dark blue portion.
Absolutely bang on. Because humne wo itna open chhod diya ki people should not. Agar main wo aur bhi elements wo sab add karunga, to what will happen? My mind will get clouded. The message will get blocked.
Right.
So create minimum. Create text jitna minimum, elements jitna minimum. In fact, at times nil. Something like this, which is so important. If you can see, baju mein un log ne dale elements. You know, but when it's on...
Yeah. Repetitive elements are also there.
Exactly. So that is the repetition. Wow. Next.
And the alignment of the paragraphs in
exactly.
Center.
Alignment bhi hai. Exactly. Wow. Next.
Proximity is also there because it's divided.
Exactly. So I'm very happy because proximity is absolutely division. You know, the artwork is being divided. So that is proximity. And let's say, I'll tell you one more thing. This is nothing but a brochure which will be in threefold.
Right.
For all of you, SI design banta hai. Bahut log honge jinko ye idea nahi hoga. Ye design banne ke baad threefold hota hai. Okay, so us case mein, let's understand how proximity would work. In that case, okay, I have to change the color. The proximity will work this way. Icons on one side, company on one side. When we are considering just this much of the artwork, jo fold hoga, jo kyunki main jab abhi jab dekhunga, sirf ye dikhega mere ko. First page hoga ye mere iska. This will be page number 1. This will be page number 2. And this will be page number 3. Last mein aap unko action karwa rahe ho. Enroll now. First understand about. First know. Sorry, not understand. First you know about us. Page number 1. Know about us. Page number 2. Understand about us. Who we are, what we do, or what we can give to you. Understand. And last page pe kya kiya unhone? Action de diya aapko. Sorry, this is a unique font that I'm typing with. It's my original own self-created one. But that's something which will help you understand ki how simply these concepts merge in any creation, jo maine abhi principles aapko bataye, itna simply wo merge hota hai. But आप बाय डिफॉल्ट कर रहे हो या समझ के कर रहे हो, दैट इज मोर. बाय डिफॉल्ट कर रहे हो तो फ्लूक होता है, कभी वो फ्लूक कभी अच्छा क्रिएट हुआ कभी नहीं हुआ. बट व्हेन यू विल स्टार्ट यूजिंग दीज प्रिंसिपल्स, इट विल नेवर बी अ फ्लूक, इट विल बी गुड डिजाइंस. ओके, सो ऑलवेज कीप दैट इन माइंड. ओके, सो मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट वंस. क्लियर? ओके. Again, I'll quickly explain. Can I ask Binayji to come online and quickly explain the next one? Binay, you're there? Can you hear us? Hello? Okay, since we've already pushed the time limits, I'll not wait for someone to respond. I'll quickly explain these things. Here we have the negative space created. The alignments are there. Okay. Now this is something which is clearly bifurcated into two. Very clearly. How we have bifurcated? With elements. Laptop, sketch pens, mobile, coffee mug. Bifurcation. So that also gets taken care of. Alignment gets taken care of. So almost all the principles which we have seen here, discussed over here. Okay, I'll just go back to the normal view so that it's again and again, I'm bringing this in front of you all so that this mind map gets fit into your brain of principles of layouting, focal points, alignment, contrast, negative space, proximity, and repetition. Again and again, I'm bringing this so that this goes right into your brain. Coming back to this one. Okay. Again, all these images, Abhi, the way you will see, it will help. But coming to the main image, I want to explain this. A couple of people have left. Maybe it was because of the worry of coming onto the screen to discuss that. But Kanchanji, since you explained the earlier one really well, can you just try this one as well?
One is the negative space, which we have clearly demarcated.
Absolutely.
The proximity is there because there's a division in between the text and the image.
Right. And, but here, can we see how nicely they are talking about a journey?
Yeah.
Read this. First, user applies via website. I'll just increase the size of it so that it's visible a little bit more, because it's important to see how it is being designed. So here it is written, user applies via website. So they have shown a laptop. Okay. They have put an icon. User details are sent to the bank. So they have given a briefcase since it is a lock. User details, so important, so exclusive and not to be shared. So there is a briefcase which is locked. Bank verifies detail and credit score before. It's a journey. And in the end, user is informed about status of credit card.
Mm-hmm.
So as we discussed earlier, okay, in this slide, that we want to show a journey. We saw in this one as well. This one. It's a journey. First, know about the company. Understand about us, what we can give. Third, enroll, action. So here in this artwork, basically, these, you know, see these things also. It's actually, I wish they could have put a simple arrow as well. Because that would have been an indication ki it is going this way.
Yeah.
Now I had to tell you all, this is a journey. And in that case, most of the time, wo jab bolna pade na, to visual cue banaya humne. That is a miss in this artwork. Aap log jab banao, ye chota chota cheez jo user ko easily, I should be able to easily understand that this is a journey. they've tried to create the visual, just missed one element.
Mm.
That is where the loser could, yeah, they can get back and say, Baba, this didn't work. For a simple reason, उसने एक arrow नहीं डाला. तो किसी को समझा नहीं कि अच्छा पहले ये होगा, फिर ये होगा, फिर ये होगा. वो समझा नहीं. It's small details. So, I hope all of you all have understood. It was a very good attempt, especially Kanchanji, you've understood really well. Even Swati, it was really good attempt. I'm really happy that what we learned today, as you know, and already I think we've taken time for summary already. What I want you to do is for as an assignment. So this is the assignment for the day. Do it, because this will help you to quickly understand what we are, you know, talking about, and register it forever. आप लोगों हमेशा ये दिमाग में रहे. Search two images of each layout principle. Search just two images. You can search more. Okay, Roshan is just joining in. I'll ask him to attempt one quickly. So this is the assignment. Search two images of each layout principle as an example. We will discuss it in the next class. Because that will open up your brains in terms of, okay, now I read something, now I understood something. Now when you go and search, you will see a lot more examples. What we did today was just few examples. So search for two images of each layout principle. We will discuss it in the next class. And yes, till then, make sure that, you know, next session we will start the softwares. And I hope today's session was really, really informative.
Yeah.
And any queries, just last couple of minutes we can take and thereafter end the session. So any queries, please go ahead and shoot the questions. Anyone, Swati, Chiranjeev ji, Roshan, Kanchanji, anyone.
See, many a times we need to design some brochures which are more complicated and requires very minimal negative space which is left.
Yes.
So in particular time, it becomes really cumbersome for designing.
Yes.
To be put it like that, that it is explanatory so that the story comes out, the journey comes out.
Right.
And we also wanted to give it a negative space to have that breathing element.
Space as well.
But space as well. But how to design the layout, I think that time layout plays a very big role.
Yes, yes. See, there is a software called as InDesign. It is specifically for layouting.
Okay.
When we teach our graphic designing master courses, we teach InDesign in that. See, InDesign is being used by newspapers. It's being used by multiple magazine editing purposes.
Mm-hmm.
Over there, you must have seen there is so much of text.
Mm-hmm.
Especially the newspaper. But still, they somehow manage to bring a balance between images and text.
True.
So that is being done with the help of that software, especially when it comes to layouting. However, what we need to keep in mind is the reader's perspective.
Okay.
So by that, what do I mean? For example, today I am someone who is walking on the street and watching your ad. So if your client is telling bombard the inputs, you should inform him that it is not possible. When you're creating a poster, you can create, let's say, 50% of that much bombarding. Because a person will stand, read, absorb. But he doesn't have leisure period to read the entire information. But when he's reading a newspaper, when he's reading a magazine, when he's reading a brochure, again, brochure is something which I would, you know, put in between the, what we call it, the newspaper and the poster. It should be somewhere in between. Yes, yes. Because it should be the right combination of text versus, yes, the person reads in leisure period, but the main purpose of brochure is that that person understands. So have to be given breathing space. Again, we are all talking in terms of what we learned today.
Correct.
So this is something, these concepts are something which are so valuable. The amount that I am charging, it is of no way anything, because we just want to create name for the brand, that what we can teach is something which is not available in the market so easily. And the way I can explain with my experience, it will help even more. And that is how we want you all to understand and give importance to concepts, and then whatever software, that is secondary. So always keep in mind, when it comes to negative space, we have to understand exactly what are we catering to, or which audience, what will be his state while he will read my artwork. Is he going by car? Is he walking? Is he sitting? Is he in a reading mode? Which mode is he on? And based on that, you get, it's like, you know, how your phone has settings. Mm-hmm. When it's on vibrating mode, it has different settings. When mm-hmm. it's on local outdoor mode, it has full volume.
Correct.
So that understanding, and I'm really happy that you have that these questions, because these are the minute details which, when you work on your artworks, they become phenomenally good, professional as well. That's how it is. Great question again. Yeah. Okay. So any other questions? Okay. All right. So we end the session. I hope this was an informative one, and something which you try to rack your brain. Are ye kya hai? Samajh mein nahi aa raha hai. Samajh mein nahi aa raha hai. That is the most important thing. Something new, something which will just make you rack your brain and are, this is something nice. I'm getting confused. That confusion will take you to the next level. Okay. All right. So thank you so much. We'll see you tomorrow. Sure. And till then, search for those two images per principle of layouting. That will definitely do the last thing that is needed for the day. All right. Go ahead. Best of luck. Have a great day. Good night, everyone.
Thank you so very much.
Thank you. Bye.